So listen, Dan Garthwaite is in the house. Do you guys know Dan Garthwaite? Dan Garthwaite, raise your hand. I would call Dan Garthwaite one of the hardest working people in fucking New Hampshire. He has a full-time fucking job doing who knows what. But that motherfucker is subjected to every single legislative session in the New Hampshire House. Is that not true, Dan? He watches every single boring bill in the New Hampshire House. If you don't listen to Dan, then you ain't bullshit. Oh, wow, that was fucking weak. But is Erica Nicole here? I think I see her. She's not wearing her pork fest outfit, but how about the pork fest cheerleader? How about the sponsors of pork fest? How about Seiko CAI? If that's all you can cheer for Seiko CAI, fuck you. I want to see a real cheer for Seiko CAI. Jason Osborne is a hero in the Liberty Movement. And I mean that. You guys, fuck you. All right, well, don't make me come down there because I'm very liable to jump down. By the way, who said do it? Because I'll kick your ass. It was probably Taron Lupo. He knows I'll kick his fucking fat ass. By the way, I really, really want fucking Jamie Crane back up on the stage. Oh! Look who fucking got on stage. Carla. Carla, I'm drunk. And you're on stage, and I have the mic, and you don't. I like your husband, but he don't have the mic. Fuck you, Stefan. Shut the fuck up. All right.
For once.
Yeah, for once. That man never shuts up. His wife must literally have like a cap on their amount of internet access, because you can tell when his video ends, his wife like shuts him the fuck up. Because he could go on forever about nothing.
I'm sorry, are you accusing me of going on forever about nothing? Really? do you wanna pull that weapon out? At least I don't do it in Hawaiian shorts.
I paid for this microphone, Mr. Speaker. Yeah, only you fucking intelligent fucks got that joke. So listen, the next person who's gonna speak is a man that I actually met by accident. I met him about 4 years ago, and I actually asked him permission for something. And people who know me say, Chris, you asked permission for something? I've been married for 14 years. I asked permission for my wife. I have 3 fucking children, Jamie, so obviously I've had sex 4 times. Unlike you. But I sent an email to Ernie, and he probably doesn't remember this, about 4 years ago. And I said, that Revolution logo I love. I want to use it. And I think Ernie sent me something. Maybe it wasn't Ernie. Maybe it was his minions like Drew. Sent me back this, fuck you. Copy it, use it, steal it, use it, send it, spray it. I don't give a fuck. Get it the fuck out there, Revolution. And we did. And then I had the privilege of meeting, was it 2 years ago? We met like in face-to-face like 2 years ago. And Ernie got to speak about the Revolution in New Hampshire at the Liberty Forum. And it was great to hear him speak direct about the Revolution. And here, hey, are you not talking? Are you talking while I'm talking? Because seriously, my daughter talks when I'm talking, and I lock her in the basement with lettuce. That's not really encouraging me. So, Yeah, Carla's like, Chris, you're drunk and you're trying to like get the crowd going. Shut up, Carla. Because I can say this when your husband's out there. So listen, Ernie had a pretty big influence on me about the revolution and putting signs up. It was actually pretty awesome because my daughter, there's this one corner in Henniker, New Hampshire, who Ernie probably has no idea where Henniker, New Hampshire is. And my daughter, who's 7 years old, says, there's a revolution going on in Henniker because no one can reach that fucking sign. It's like 40 feet up and there's a revolution sign up. And I know it was on Ernie's guys. And it's put up and no one can ever take it down. And it will be there forever. Yeah. Alcohol abuse. But it can never be taken down. And I know for a fact it was on Ernie's guys. There's a revolution going on in Henniker, New Hampshire because of Ernie in Arizona. Please welcome Ernie Hancock.
Well, it's that high because that year you had like 40 feet of snow. You know, I've always been a real fan of New Hampshire because when we started the Lovolution, you know, it just kicked in New Hampshire and we never thought we had to even come here. We were busy the rest of the country. It wasn't because we thought we didn't like you or something. We didn't come to New Hampshire. It's because you guys were already doing it. So we were really happy about that. You know, this is for Stefan Molyneux, and I know a lot of these guys from the road and got just a little bit to say about them. You know, but I tell you, I gotta say something about Carla. You know, it's amazing, you know, that how much you go against monarchies and you don't want to have, you know, kings and queens and so on, but you can be my queen anytime. You can even be on top. Yeah. She'd be my queen. Right after my wife. I forgot that part. No. Cool. You know, you guys, you young guys don't get this. Let me tell you. I had the word we're not supposed to say. Well, I never got that fucking contract, okay? Nobody told me anything. I'm coming down, I'm thinking, you know, the first time I saw Stefan Molyneux was, it was like 08 or something. Like, that was a long time ago. And it was Statism is Dead, Matrix 13. Any of you guys ever watch that one? No. You know, it's, yeah, right. It was the one that I was like, he goes, you know, the end of Free Range, and has all these chickens out in the field. You know, does the images. And he goes, the end of Free Range, and has the chickens out there, is not freedom. And then he shows the chicken McNugget box. And I go, oh, you know, I don't even need to watch any more of his. I already get it. And the only person that I know that can even compete with him, be an anarchist, is someone that served fucking time like Larkin Rhodes. Yeah, and he plays a guitar too. He had plenty of time to practice it. You know, and the one thing we give, you guys give a lot of hard time to the Phoenix crowd and so on. That's cool because we can take it. You know, we got titanium testicles, man, and then and then. And the thing is that, and the thing about Drew, you know, you think he rides, any of these guys rides on anybody. I ride on all of them. I just tell the stories of all the cool stuff that they do. Like Drew came up with a dime card idea. What do you think of that? And that's why we were drunk at the Freedom Summit. You know, and we're just sitting there, you know, talking about it. And there was a guy at the gun show that day that was trading silver for bullets and back and forth. And so on. We're going, cool, silver bullets, man, right on. And we started thinking. And all of a sudden, Nick of Cop Block, you hear his podcast. Nick is like, he blows his beer everywhere. And we're going, say it, man, say it. And he goes, the Coors Light train. Get all aboard the love train. The silver bullet and so on. So that's how that started. So we were really excited about it. I was here last year doing the show live. And they were back in the control room going, we're so fucking going to PorcFest. So they started planning a year ago. 4409. A lot of you guys don't know how much he's been face to face with cops and just said no. And sometimes you just gotta sit down to stand up. And I know a lot of people do this, like Adam Kokesh, you know. I gotta ask Adam, I just wondered, You know, we're looking for an alternative currency. Did he bring rubles or something? You know, is it that bad, really, seriously, that we're looking, you know, maybe we'll go in rubles? You know, maybe think about it. You know, I'm one of the old guys. I used to be considered one of the young guys like you. You know, and then I get older and I start, you know, and this morning I go in to shave and I'm like, I forgot my razor. I had everything but my razor. I gotta shave. It's gray. I gotta shave. But the thing is that now we look at all of you. Yeah, I know. I noticed it when finally for the first time I was in a car with the top down. I got a black Mustang convertible rented because my penis is really small. They asked to upgrade, and I go, oh, yeah, that's right. I'm middle-aged now. Stefan, you know, I wanted to, you know, just warn you. Because, you know, Carla, she gave me this this packet of Kool-Aid. And a lot of you young guys don't know this. Let me tell you a story without saying the naughty word. There was a guy, they call it the Temple of whatever the heck, and he took his flock, and they are, we believe, we're going to move to Guyana, New Hampshire. No, I mean down in Central America. And then people started, you know, getting on them and so on, and it comes down some congressmen, so they shot them, and I didn't really have a problem with that. But, you know, so it started getting really bad, and they drank cyanide Kool-Aid, okay? So they started giving out the Kool-Aid. Now, don't drink the Kool-Aid. So I wanted to warn Stefan. I'm going, look, man, you don't want to have all of these guys clinging on to like your Guyanaville, because then you got to have responsibility for all the crazy shit that they do. You know, it's like, oh my God. But you know, the thing is that I just want to make sure you guys know. Oh, Taryn, don't think I forgot about you, man. I get to you. I just want to make sure that you guys don't make sure anarchy works. You know, because we've been looking for it for so long, and he articulates it so well. And all it takes is, you know, one individual to totally fuck it up, you know. But what does everybody do? You just, hey, man, there was no group. That guy was just a crazy guy on his own, because we're all on our own. And you think like that, things are cool. I met Jamie and Taryn down at a Libertarian Party thing in Missouri where I was speaking. And I never met them before, and I couldn't tell. Are you guys competing for who's most gay or least gay or what? You know, and then he had all our followers are homos, you know, and I'm going, wow, man, you know, but they're cool. We got to know each other personally. We were having a good time. I knew it was their shtick and so on. But, you know, Taryn, I thought he was gay. And then we're driving to the airport. I'm taking the airport. And his wife calls, and she's pissed. I mean, I can hear it over his earpiece. She's just going, and he's sitting in there, and we're talking serious philosophical shit, you know? And he's just, and he's getting chewed out by his wife because didn't have cell coverage where we were, and she needed to know, and the flight, and hit, and you need to be, and that. And she's trying to help him, and he's not calling her back, and she's just going off, and he was just, and he hangs up on her. Oh, that phone vibrated for the next hour. You are so fucking in trouble. So he worked everything out. It was all good. But, you know, I always remembered that. I go, no, he's married. So then, you know, Catherine Bleich. Oh, and John Bush. Oh, you got to do it. You know, this is the picture immediately. You know, I'm going, cool, it's great that this generation is starting to have children. They go, what would you never bring, you know, children into a world like this? Hell, it's why we fucking have kids, is to fix a world like this. So when you have the next generation comes up, you know, this is the YouTube I have in my head. You know, it's like, you know, the baby, you know, she's screaming, stop, stop, you're hurting me, stop, you know, and then you have the kid. They swallow it up. John's got it, you know. They're cradling it, and they put up, you know, they hold it like this, and then all of a sudden you see a protest flag come out of the blanket saying, "I want a divorce." Yeah. You know, so oh, and that's another. Oh yeah, Oh, yeah. You do even a little bit of research on Stefan, he has the anti-cultist crowd going on. I didn't know that. You know, this is because what happens? What happens when Generation Next, an entire generation, the kids, the parents, they start coming in and they start referring to them as just tax slaves and livestock, and they don't have anything to do with them anymore. You know, it's like then you start spending Thanksgiving and Christmas by choice with people you love instead of just causing pain. But, you know, we really need to share the love with our family and our friends and our neighbors and show them what it's like to be peace-loving people and go here and that. They can just smoke a little bit of marijuana on stage if they want to. I want to. What? I really, really want. God damn, man. I was just checking, man. I was just trying to get. A freebie. I'm done, man. I'm done. I don't know all you young guys, you new guys, but I tell you, man, our future is in such good hands, and I'm so happy. This Pork Fest. You know what it's like? The Libertarian Party was like the high school dance. You know, and then you went there to find out where the real party was, and you went there.
The next man up is a man who spent more days in prison than I've spent married, I think. The man who I've talked to, no, not Mark Edge. Mark Edge is busy doing another program. This man, I've known about for quite some time. I've known about him protesting. I've known about his, like, a whole deal about him. And then I saw this thing about a dot. A tiny fucking dot. And that fucking dot had more impact than any of you fuckers. I don't care how much you talk about fucking anarchy, Mr. Mullinex. This fucking dot has had more impact on me. And honestly, if you have a simple brain, and most of you have simple fucking brains, Patrick, shut the fuck up. I didn't ask you to talk. This fucking guy has really simplified it, has really, and I mean this in a good way, you've simplified in a way that any simple brain, like Curtis, could understand this fucking dot, this tiny fucking dot. So please talk about the dot, Larkin Rose.
All I'm going to say about the dot is if you go to youtube.com/LarkinRose, you can see the video.
I'm allowed to rob you!
I noticed that Stefan is relatively unscathed so far. People have been sort of spreading out their venom. But I want to be sort of nice to everybody else and focus a little bit on Stefan. Now, he's absolutely a brilliant guy. And I think everybody here would agree that. And maybe he will go down in history as one of the great pro-liberty advocates, but there may be a couple little obstacles to that. One that comes to mind is rabble-rousing, anarchist, badass Stefan. I don't know, you know, I can hear, I am William Wallace, but I am Stefan Molyneux.
Don't worry, I'm actually just about to change it to Slasher von Molotov.
That's much better.
That's the way it's going to go.
So, but, you know, to be fair, Ludwig, Lysander, Milton, Friedrich. So I guess he's in pretty good company. We'll let that slide. But, kind of hard to figure him out entirely. Name is French, accent's British, and he's Canadian. I'm not sure he's a real person. Now, I have a couple of theories about his actual origin. One, now this is a fairly obscure reference that some of you will know. You see a disembodied head and shoulders with a colorful but simple background. He's Max Headroom. Austrian economics. So he just got a little older and got a little more sophisticated and changed his career. And so I decided he's not actually a real person. He's a hologram, and you notice you don't see him around that much because it takes too much effort to keep the hologram going, and it's too much chance for a mess up and people will notice. And I think he totally rents his pretty wife and cute kid to look like a human being. I do, however, have an alternative theory about his origin, which is he grew up in the Deep South, and he was always saying, "The controllers and these control freaks, they view us as livestock." And he ranted on and on, and nobody paid any attention to him. And this PR guy walked by and said, "I like your message, but to a lot of the country, it's going to come across, you know, they're not really going to respect it." So after years of perfecting his fake accent, he now says, "They view you as livestock." And everybody pays attention to him.
Shit, son, you got me.
Damn, he's good.
So yeah, he's a good rebel rouser. But there, like I said, there's a couple objections that maybe he doesn't quite all the way fit in. Slight modifications of the sayings we've heard. You know, "Patrick Henry, I know not what others may choose, but as for me, give me liberty or give me death." Stefan Molyneux, "Give me liberty or I will pontificate at great length about the moral superiority of allowing me my freedom."
I think some people prefer death to that.
Doesn't quite have the same ring to it, but oh well. And just as one last thought, Thomas Paine was quoted to have said, "If there be trouble, let it be in my day, that my child may have peace." Stefan Molyneux, "If there be trouble, let it be in the States while I watch from Canada."
Says the man who spent a lot of time in federal prison. How did that hurt? By the way, do you guys all know Linda Lagana? Linda's like, "Fuck you, Chris, I hate you." "No, Linda, you love me." Linda, stand up. Give a big round of applause to Linda Lagana. This banner up here to my right is Liberty Act, her new thing. She made a lot of the Ron Paul stuff from 2007, 2008. Linda Lagana, you rock. You're still gay, Larkin Rose, no matter what Linda does. By the way, it's okay because it was prison. Now, Bob Murphy's next. Now, Bob, I have three very young children. And one of the things about Bob that they know about is you can spell it the same forwards and backwards. Not too hard for my three-year-old. And they said, "So tell me about this Bob Murphy guy." Well, I said, "Well, he believes that the price of things should be the real price, not the fake federal price." And my son, he goes, "Dad, no shit. Why shouldn't it be the real price, not the fake price?" He goes, "Why the fuck did this guy go to college to know about this shit?" I said, "I have no fucking idea why he went to college. I knew about the real shit about my sophomore year of college. I dated this girl, and I think she's not here, but she was earlier. And she sent me 19 beers to my table. It was 25 cents a beer. That was what I was worth back then. And she said, he's about 19 beers worth. And I said, yeah, that's true. Things always find their equilibrium. And that's economics. Would you not agree, Jason Osborne? Jason Osborne will probably show you his tattoo, sober or non-sober, because it's on his, like, his real place. But if you want to see my tattoo, hold on a second. Oh, in other words, I'll just introduce a man who knows really about economics, Bob, forwards and backwards, Murphy.
All right, everybody, let's give it up for Chris Lawless. It's a thankless job to be up here, and the good thing about Chris is the longer he goes, the more confident I was getting in the material I had prepared. I was like, these guys are going to like this shit after him. So I have to apologize. I didn't actually like bring notes and stuff because I thought, like, you know, you can memorize 10 things in a chemistry exam in high school, so I thought, you know, we would have to write stuff down. I realized most of these people haven't gotten through high school. So, I thought we were supposed to make fun of each other. That was the whole point, not, you know, talk about our shows and stuff. This is me. Let's say, is Sovereign Curtis, yeah, there he is. Let's give it up for him. Now, the thing about Curtis is now, you guys as the attendees might not know this, but those of you who are like sort of behind the scenes and involved, like a lot of us are in giving talks, we all know that what Curtis has done has taken this whole spontaneous order thing and just run with it, all right? He is the anti-central planner of PorcFest. Okay, I see the spontaneous order was a bit above your comprehension, yeah. Okay, let's tone it down for the crowd, all right. All right, what else we gotta talk about? I prepared an impression for you guys. I think you'll enjoy it. I just hope you find it. Tell me if you know who this is. I'm Uncle Sam. I'm gonna get good. Now, I don't know that girl. I'm hoping that was because she's stoned and I'm not like making fun of Corky or something. Is that okay? What else can I talk about? Okay, PorcFest. All right, this is my first time here. I feel a little bit of an outsider. I mean, you guys all know each other and stuff. But I am having a good time. There's one thing, though. Don't get me wrong. I'm talking about the vendors here, the food. The food tastes awesome. I'm not complaining about the taste of it. My only concern is I've been here for 3 days so far, and my bowel movements have been primarily liquid. Is that... I'll always think of it fondly as Diarrhea Fest 2011.
Can I move?
Yeah.
Would that be okay? Just left or right? Either way. Or if anyone has an umbrella, that would be great.
Okay. All right, who else we got to talk about? Let's see. That dog. Okay, I did prepare some jokes about Adam here, but I saw his arms and good day to you too, sir. Thank you, yes. What else we got? Is Jamie still around, or did he decide to leave? Jamie said, hey, Jamie, no matter how much you drink, you're still going to be you. What else we got here? Yeah, that Wheels Off Liberty is a good... I confess, I hadn't listened to that before. It was my first time hearing it the other night. And it was... the term highbrow did not come to mind. You know, so you guys, you sort of pushing the envelope. You know, you guys are into like homeschooling, you know, unschooling, and they push it one more to uneducated. But no, I mean, I kid. We're all, you know, doing our part in the movement. You know, I'm working on business cycle theory. You know, Dan D'Amico, if he's here, you know, he works on prison privatization, that kind of stuff. Roderick Long's looking at Aristotelian philosophy and its application to free market economics. And you guys are talking about anal sex. So, I mean, it's just, you know, we all play a small part in the liberty movement. You guys got that one covered. So who else are we going to talk about? I guess Carla. Let's see. What can we say about Carla? Well, I mean, obviously what we're trying to do up here is we're trying to be cool, like Comedy Central, and we're going to roast people. You know, so this alternate universe, Stefan is David Hasselhoff, right? I'm special celebrity guest Jason Alexander, right?
George is getting very angry!
Right? And Carla is so not Pamela Anderson at all. Because there's one big difference. She has much bigger brains. What did you guys think I was talking about? All right, I'm sort of out of material. Is there anything I'm forgetting to talk about? Oh yeah, it was like in my professional career, I forgot you were here. So, Stefan, I mean, first of all, as others have alluded to this, but that accent is so fake. What are you doing with that accent? I mean, it's not like, oh, because I'm from Canada. I mean, Mike Myers doesn't sound like that, right? It's not a Canadian. So I think what he did with that is, you know, you start with William Shatner, right? You know, Scotty, we need more power, okay? Then you add Sean Connery, Junior. We're going the wrong way. My diary is in Berlin, right? Okay, those two. Then the third element, you take a copy of The Fountainhead and you insert into your rectum. And that is how you make Stefan Molyneux.
And it has to be the hardcover.
Yeah, the hardcover.
Hardcover, absolutely.
What do you think we're talking about here? All right, we're hardcore. All right, what else can we say about Stefan? Let's see. Well, the thing about Stefan is, though, that he's refreshingly honest, right? Because no matter what kind of interview you're listening to, in contrast to other radio hosts and podcast hosts who are like real full of themselves or something, you can listen to Stefan interview anybody, and several times throughout the episode, he will say how he is not qualified to be talking about that subject at all. Have you noticed that?
Now, of course, I don't really know about this, but I think I'll ask you anyway.
No, he really does that. It's funny. Well, I guess, you know, the thing is, we make fun of him and stuff, but of course we all love him, and it's true. I look at Stefan and I say, you know, that's kind of the career path I would have chosen if I couldn't get a PhD.
How much money did I save? Yes, it was quite a lot.
Yeah. And it's true, though. A lot of us, you know, and we kid and stuff, but we sit around and, you know, those of us who, you know, have PhDs, we write books that are actually like in Barnes & Noble. You know, we testify before Congress, you know, that kind of stuff. And we all sit around, and this is true, though. I think I speak for all those guys when we say, why are you so popular? It's not fair. Seriously, go to his Wikipedia page. His Wikipedia page is like, Stefan Molyneux, world-renowned philosopher, blah, 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 blah. His former job was fixing hard drives. Well, in summary, I think I would just like to say, Stefan, that if you were half as important as you think you are, SEAL Team 6 would have already killed you. Thank you.
How many people here fired a gun before? How many people have fired a gun properly before? Notice how Adam Kokesh goes, no, fuck me, I learned from the Army. Or excuse me, was it the Marines? Or was it both? Or was it neither? So, do you know that there's a couple here who donated more than some companies that they wanted to make sure that people, like kids, have had the proper way to learn shit, and also that people learn how to shoot guns properly, which may sound like fucked up to people, but if you have kids, you know it's true. I want to give a heads up to Alex and Kate Muller, who actually donated a shitload of money to people in order to do the bowl. And I can't pick Kate out of the crowd right now, but her, like, passion, stand up. Yeah, I know it's going to take you a while. She has two passions in life. One is to teach you how to shoot straight, and the one, women, be quiet, the one is for you ugly fucking libertarian males to dress fucking properly. No. What me? Who's Chris, talking?
Chris,
have you... wearing a fucking collar tonight.
Have you looked down at all, Chris? Look down. What do you see?
I see a big dick, Stefan. What do you see?
Well, this is the problem with this seat. All I see is ass. You guys have a great view. All I get to see is ass, and some of them are extensive.
Lucky you, Stefan. Lucky you. So listen, Stefan has a hearing and eyesight problem. But Kate and Alec, thank you for being what great people you are for New Hampshire. Kate busts her ass in New Hampshire to teach kids stuff, to teach women how to shoot. And Alec, believe it or not, over 25% of the FSP movers have lived in Alec's house. So thank you, Kate and Alec. So if you don't know where to live, 4012 Central Ave, I think. I don't live there. Like the fuck I would live with you fucking people. By the way, someone goes, would you ever live with Stefan? Seriously? I got a wife and three kids. Like, I would ever live with that fucking guy? Or Bob, you fucking bald fucker. There's only room enough for one bald fucker in the house. So listen, Pink Floyd, what have you drank tonight? Yeah, so listen, I know most of the roasters tonight. I most of them know most of them pretty well. You know, we talk about Carla, I could go on hours about Carla. Troy Von Non-Epic, hours. Larkin Rose, I got a prison sentence about that fucking guy. But Patrick, he goes, I was born in Nashua. I'm like, is that all you had to fucking say to me? Is you were born in New Hampshire? I'm an anarchist. All right, so you're born smarter than the rest of us. I mean... But what do you have to say about Stefan Mullinex? And he goes, nothing really. I'm here. I go, well, fuck, Patrick, by all means, fucking step over to the stage and talk. I mean, Patrick, come on up from Nashua.
Let's hear it for alcoholism, everybody. We're here today to honor what many of us think is a great man. He's a writer, he's a philosopher, he's an author. He's great at just about everything except for Googling fucking acronyms. FDR, that's the opposite of what you stand for. But if you want to write a great econ paper, that's the site to source. A lot of people really like your video, Stefan. I think I could sound deep too if piano music started playing every time I talked about something. I have notes. Oh, I remember I saw you at the Liberty Forum. You said that you advertise on your roof, FDR. You're lucky Canada's Air Force is six geese with slingshots. In America, that'd be a target from the Nabomb. There was a restricted topic tonight. Like six people have already said it, so I guess it's not that restricted. Your Wikipedia page actually has a little sentence about it. But if you are a cult leader, you suck as a cult leader. I mean, he doesn't have facial hair. Even the top of his head said, fuck it. Yeah, I guess you could be an alright cult leader. Hail Stefan! It's close. I sacrificed a goat to him last week. that was pretty alright. I got more on this paper, but that's a good suggestion. This was not a joke, but at the Liberty Forum, we spoke briefly. He said that you could tell that I was a troublemaker. When I got back to school, I caused a paper shortage printing out copies of his book. This is true. I respect the hell out of you. You turned me from a little L anarchist, or little L fucking libertarian, into an anarchist. And you made me the best debater in the Nashua area. I look forward to someday reading your obituary. Either you're going to get assassinated, or a seagull is going to mistake your head for a rock and jump a turtle on it. That's all I got, so smash the state, eh?
Woo! Thank you.
I have no fucking clue who Patrick is, but I like that fucking guy. Come on, give it up for Patrick. I mean, you talk about a turtle dropping on fucking Stefan's head, so that's good. And this kind of a little disconcerts me, but Jamie's sitting next to Catherine right now. So maybe you are her baby daddy. I was looking at John all night, but well done, Jamie. Well done. So there's this guy who he said, "Chris, you dress like shit." I said, "I'm not wearing a fucking Hawaiian shirt tonight, so I'm a step above them last year." And he goes, "Chris, at Brooks Brothers, we dress the best." And then he sends me an email tonight, "I'm sorry, I'm a fucking douche." Is that paraphrasing? No, you weren't sorry? No, I think you said you were something like a fucking pussy douche or something. But he goes, "I'm a douche, but I'll give you a discount. But I'm funny." And I said, "No, you're probably not really." But he goes, "I'm wearing a fucking tuxedo shirt. So that fucking Stefan guy, I'll fuck with him all night, and I'll be the funniest fucker tonight, Troy Vaughn Epic!"
Fuck iPads, okay? I stopped drinking, so I now eat my alcohol.
Delia makes these excellent jello shots. Delia! I think she's still over there. You can get some. They're great. All right, let me make sure this thing works here. Oh, shit.
And I'd like to tell everyone that my view just doesn't include ass now, but also underwear. So the show is just getting as good for me as it is for you. Thank you.
That's all I've got. All right, well, my computer broke, so I'm going to try and remember the four jokes I wanted to tell. Shit. I think what I was going to do was not drink.
Okay, long-winded, bald, cult. What was the other one? Long-winded. Repetitive.
All right. In all fairness, when Curtis sent me an email saying how butthurt he would be if I told a cult joke, I promised him I wouldn't tell cult jokes, so I didn't write any cult jokes. No cult jokes, sorry. Hate to let you down. Also, Sovereign Curtis, where are you at? Because this is what aviators look like. They say Ray-Ban on them, and they're not from Hot Topic. Okay, just wanted to point that out. The Jefferson Memorial Dancing with the Stars champion is here. His partner dropped him, but I think they came through for the win in the end. Shut down the house, I heard. That's good stuff. But, you know, whatever. It's cool. You tried. Were you at Buzz's party? Exactly. You got to practice to get better. Hi, Chris.
Hi, how are you?
You've had way too much to drink, so I'm not even going to bother. But I would like to point out that Madras went out in the 60s, and
it just came back in.
I wish it did. I got a suit. And this is what nice pants look like, buddy. Look at these. I was going to wear a dress for you. No one's a bigger pussy than you. But anyways, we came here today to celebrate one of the greatest philosophers and thinkers to ever come out of Canada. But since William Shatner could not be here tonight, and since Michael Steele was off making pornos, we had to settle for Stefan. Not a bad third place choice, if you ask me. You know, what else can you say about a guy who's done so much for a movement? You know, he's given us so much information. He's given us a lot of new ways to look at things. You know, he's just opened a lot of doors for a lot of people. And I feel like if that person were here tonight, I'd say something very nice about him. Oh. Talk to me, Stefan.
It's your roast, man. Please, go to town.
I don't know, man. Most of you people I'm meeting for the first time now, I'm a Facebook novelty. That's why they have me up here, and I'm just for like ticket sales or some shit. I don't know. But I think that's all I had, and that's almost all I had. The Mozingos are here too. I wanted to send a shout out to them for doing all the hard work. You know, it just makes me wonder though how someone, you know, so pretty, so talented, and so strong can get stuck with Robin. Jesus Christ. Oh wait, Erica's here. Erica! After a lot of bitching and moaning, and not the moaning that she likes to do, she made it out of West Virginia with her genitals intact. And that's saying something. I was going to do the toothbrush joke, but I'm sure everyone's heard that. God damn it. I love you. You magnificent peanut gallery. All right, I'm done because my shit's broke. I'm out of jokes.
He certainly is. The fact that he needed a laptop and smacked my ass. So, Canadians, you can't win the Stanley Cup. Get shit the fuck down. So, by the way, Adam, your chant doesn't count when you say blue. By the way, I'm friends with that dog on Facebook. It doesn't count. By the way, have you guys bought silver this weekend? Did he really unfriend me? I'll fucking him tonight. Del Valle Silver. If you don't buy the... Is Karen here tonight? That I see her? I love Karen. Karen actually found out about silver because of the Free State Project. So if you don't know about Del Valle Silver, go buy their campsite, buy their silver. And the Agorist Alchemist, I think they may get me drunk tonight. My beer is almost done. Someone would be very obliged to come up and fill my beer. If you don't, I will come to your campsite tonight. I'll follow you home. But also, this other bald motherfucker, besides this bald motherfucker, they also need beers. Is that a fair statement? By the way, Stefan says,
if I don't get a beer, then Canada might invade the U.S. Blame Canada.
Carla, South African non-apartheid girl.
That's my thing. As usually happens, I apologize for my voice, but it's pretty much an annual tradition by now. welcome, everyone, to PorcFest. I realize it's been a long night, so I'm actually not going to do a whole song and dance. The only reason I'm up here is because I was like, I don't know how it happened, but for the first time in my life, I am more sober than Chris Lawless. I'm not slurring, right? Oh, wait. All right. Sorry, I swallowed my lozenge. See, I can speak like Stefan. So I think, you know, frankly, that we should unite our forces. I have often wondered, quite frankly, whether the Free State Project might be a C word. Because, you know, we all like to eat lots of bacon. We wear these incredibly funny shoes. And perhaps we have finally found a charismatic leader. So I literally didn't prepare anything, but I thought it might be kind of funny to read my four notes that I made. The first one is, oh, actually I wanted to say something about you. Just for a second. Okay, and I mean this in the best way possible, but the only way you have permission to call someone a gimp is if you're the person who carried her off the stage. So I believe in personal responsibility and also taking care of people. So when Uncle, I guess Auntie Sam,
Break her down. We have a host down. Break her down. He's asking for CPR.
All right, first of all, where's free aid when we need them? Second of all, there is no one big enough to carry him off the stage. I ain't doing it.
That will be in slow motion on YouTube in about 9 seconds.
All right.
And in reverse. All
right, just hold on. So I'm back to Auntie Lady Sam and personal responsibility, Chris Lawless. His children and his wife aren't here. So what, your wife tells you what to do? And if she's not here, you're not personally responsible? Because you're on a slippery slope. All right, so sit your ass down, shut up, and I'm reading my notes. So the first question I have is, if we're a cult, are we a gay cult? Because, quite frankly, there was a whole lot of, I don't know, homoerotic, homosexual ass shaking going on stage. And for those of you who attended Buzz's Big Gay Dance Party, huge shout out for her. The reason I bring this up is really what we're trying to do is we're trying to build a new society. And we need these people with these ideas to help us and to guide us and to teach us. And every year I'm just, I'm gonna get a weepy. Just amazed. It's my sincere moment. It's on the teleprompter. All right, sorry, I'm back to the gimp again because I want to make this point about Ernie. I don't know much about roasting, but I will tell you this. I was sitting down there, he was sitting there, and he goes, that lady, she doesn't look good up there. I think we should go carry her off the stage. And I'm like, wow, Ernie, that's the kind of thing I like to hear. We stand up, we walk up, we get there. I take her back, get her water, get her a nurse. I come back, Ernie's sitting on stage. Ha 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 ha. All right, question. Now I sound like the judge. Question. Anyone notice the North-South Alliance we're building? Yeah, right? It's because up here, you know, we like boots, and I'm thinking we could start wearing some cowboy boots like Mr. Adam, who knows how to dance. So when I was thinking about what I could say about people, honestly, I couldn't think of anything bad to say about Adam. I was just pretty much, he stole my money once at poker at Liberty Forum many years ago. And yeah, he's hot. Sorry, honey. Bob and Larkin, we all watch their YouTubes, right? So Larkin, I think the first time I saw him on YouTube was with the I'm allowed to steal thing, right? I'm allowed to rob you. And Bob with the zombie thing, and thank you for doing zombies yesterday. I got a real kick out of it. My husband was like, who the hell's that? And the zombie mask. And I was like, that's Bob, Bob Murphy. And he's like, oh my God, fucking PorcFest is epic. Bob Murphy's walking around with a zombie face. So, question, like the judge, right? Do none of us read anymore? Every single person who was up here was like, we see it, I saw it on YouTube. What does that mean? It means technology is setting us free. It means even if Facebook is a CIA fucking database, it means that they're giving us tools that we can beat them with. You know, I was talking to someone today and they said, I actually said, I was like, oh, you know what, we should make some kind of central repository where we can get all these photos, where we can put all these videos. And someone looked at me and they were like, that's what Facebook is. And I'm like, exactly, we can all tag each other. I have met more people through Facebook in the freedom movement, and we have to stop the paranoid shit, friend each other, turn the minds of the fucking CIA! All right, so a little bit about Stefan. Because that's why we're here. You know, I think the first time I actually became super aware of you, although there had been, ooh, that sounded dirty. The first time I became super aware of you was when you came out to Liberty Forum a few years ago with the Free State Project. And I just started blogging at the time, and I was like, well, I'm gonna go, everyone's talking about this guy, I'm gonna go check it out. And we talked about this. I went to the speech, and it was very clever, and I'm sure there's a YouTube about it for all you people who can't read anymore. And he talked about the gun in the room was basically the boiling down point of that. Now, the thing about the gun in the room is...
We just need one tranquilizer gun. You can fire from the hip. Just one. Sorry, go.
All right, so tomorrow night when it's Soapbox Idol, I will have my whip with me. And I think Mr. Chris may have to have a whipping coming. Tomorrow. So, the gun in the room, right? And Stefan and I exchanged some emails because I said to him, you know, at first I actually thought the argument was elementary. And then I realized it was incredibly elegant and that there's a way to communicate with people to show them the violence. And that gun in the room thing really struck me. You know, there are philosophies that stick with you where you just go, wow, this actually changed the way I look at things. And for me, the gun in the room is the fact that freedom is not negotiable. We can't wait. We have a North-South alliance. We are moving thousands of people to one place to concentrate and to fight a war for our own freedom. And the only way you can do that is to live free every day, your own life. That's all you have to change. Thank you. I can actually wrap this up in a theory, and I swear I'm just reading my notes. So the last thing... All right, wait. Just do not knock me off the stage, because then we're going to have a fight. All right, here's the last thing I want to say. You know, the whole statism thing was... I'm sorry, the whole cult thing, you know, is a bit of a joke. I can't not say the C word either, because I don't believe in censorship. But what I want to say is truly, statism is a cult, and we choose to be free. Yeah.